Welcome to Chennai City Garden. So today in this video we are going to see about composting, how to make compost at home. That is the major concept today. So I will be sharing lots of information regarding composting and what kind of materials required to do a proper compost and what to not add in compost. So these kind of information I will be sharing in this video. So watch the video till the end so that you get all the required informations. So first we need a proper bin. You can see here I had put lots of holes on the sides of the bin and at the bottom, so that if there is any water leakage it will get out easily from the bottom. So we are going to do aerobic composting. That is the major concept today. Aerobic composting, nothing but the composting which involves oxygen or air. So there should be proper ventilation inside the compost bin. Only then the microorganisms can live in it and it can convert the waste into a compost. So that is the major concept here. So what is composting? Composting is nothing but converting organic waste into a fertilizer or plant nutrients. That is the definition for composting. So you can see here what are the things required. That is the another question. So to do a compost we need two things: carbon and nitrogen. So carbon things are nothing but dried leaves, cardboard pieces, paper. All these come under carbon. So as a first layer I'm going to add these dry leaves. You can see here all these dried leaves are from my garden. So everything what we are going to add is from home, nothing we are getting from outside. So as a first layer I'm adding the dried leaves. So I had mentioned here, you can see here. So for proper composting we need carbon 50% and nitrogen 50%. That is the major thing. So already I had mentioned what are the carbon contents: dried leaves, cardboard, paper. These all come under carbon. And for nitrogen we can use green waste, kitchen waste, grass clippings and fruit peels and vegetable peels. These kind of things you can use. So you can see here I am just dipping the cardboard pieces into the water and squeezing the water out, and I am putting the cardboard pieces into the bin. Just it needs some kind of moisture, so that's why I dipped in the water. So what we have added, you can see, first dried leaves and then cardboard pieces. Now I am going to add the nitrogen content. So first 50% carbon, 50% nitrogen. Why it should be at an equal level is, if you are adding lots of vegetable peels and different kind of rotten foods, there will be leakage of water. So for that, if there is carbon content like cardboard pieces or dried leaves, it will absorb those water. So there will be balance within the bin. So the composting process can be done very easily. Now I am adding soil at the top of these two, the nitrogen and the carbon content. Why I am adding soil is, soil contains lots of beneficial bacteria. This is garden soil. Now I am adding fermented buttermilk. You can see here. Why I am adding fermented buttermilk is, it contains lots of bacteria. It will initiate the compost process. That's why I am adding the buttermilk. We can add different kind of things to initiate the composting process. So as a first layer we have added these three things, carbon, nitrogen and then soil. The same way again I will be adding the cardboard pieces, the carbon content, and again the nitrogen content, then the soil. So you can follow these steps. This will be easy for you to understand how the composting is taking place. Another bacteria content is the cow dung slurry. This contains lots of bacteria, so we can add this two into the bin. So you can have, I mean, you can ask the question why you are adding all these things. I mean, the cow dung slurry, the buttermilk and the soil. You can add any two of those three. Now I am again adding these vegetable peels, fruit peels, all those things. So like this, you can add it daily until the bin has been completely filled upon. The eggshells, whatever organic waste you have in your home, you can put it into this bin. You should not put any of these waste into the dustbin. So it can be converted into plant nutrients. So you have to keep it in mind that you should not put any of these waste into dustbin. Now I'm adding tea grounds. You can see here. So these kind of waste we are generating, I mean, on a day-to-day life, in every home, these wastes are generated and they are put into dustbin and it will be taken to a separate dumping yard. So we don't need to add these things into the dustbin. You can put it in the compost bin itself. So like this, you have to add on a day-to-day basis. So as I had already mentioned, the microorganisms can be added by adding these three things: buttermilk, cow dung slurry, and then garden soil. All these three contains bacteria. So these are easy to get. So you can add these things into your compost bin. So generally, within 2.5 months, you can get the converted compost. So what you can do is buy at least 3 to 4 bins like this and add the waste on a daily basis. Once the one bin completes, you can add it to the next bin. So you can go on adding this waste into it. So within 2.5 months, the first bin will be converted into complete compost. You can add those compost into the plants. You can just add one handful of this compost into one plant. That will be enough for the plant to grow really well. So every 2 to 3 days, you should turn the pile. Only then the microorganisms can move along the bin, and there will be ventilation. I mean, there will be oxygen into it. The aeration will be properly maintained. So you have to turn the pile for every 3 days so that the aeration is proper. Don't add too many rotten things into it. Don't add milk products or meat products. You can see here, these are the cautions. Don't add any oily substances. Don't add too many rotten materials. Don't add any meat and milk products. So only these things you have to check upon. So you can see here, this is the finished compost. This is called black gold. Before 2.5 months I had started it. Now it has been completely done. I had added many kind of things, but there is no smell in it. It is just proper compost. You will not be able to smell anything. What I had added, many kind of fruit peels, many vegetable peels, nothing you can smell upon. It's just, there is no smell at all. It's like soil. This contains lots of nutrients. Like this, you can convert the waste into proper compost in your home. So you no need to put this waste into dustbin. So waste management is a big problem throughout the world. So everybody have to understand that these waste need not be put into a bin and then taken into a separate place and dumped there. I had seen a dumping yard where all the waste are put upon, daily waste are taken into there. So if you had, any of our viewers had seen the dumping yard, please mention it in the comment. Because only if we see that dumping yard, we can feel the effect of waste that we are putting on a daily basis. It spoils everything. It spoils the air, the dumping yard. It spoils the air, the water, the soil, everything it spoils. It leaves out methane. It spoils the soil. The toxic contents get into the soil and it spoils everything. It spoils the water under the soil and also the air. So these kind of problems it is creating. So it is better to put those waste into a bin like this and prepare a proper compost. So if we have, I mean, if everybody in the home has a proper bin, then there won't be lots of waste that is getting into the dumping yard. So it is better for our environment if we use this method to prepare the compost. So please follow this method to prepare the compost. Once the compost has been converted, you will feel what kind of importance it is for the environment and you will feel satisfied because you are not putting any kind of organic waste into the dustbin. So I had that feeling first time. I mean, when I started composting, I had felt really good. So you should also feel that. So if anybody who are not doing composting, please buy a bin or a plastic bucket in your home and start composting today itself. So that is what I want to say. So if you like this video, please like and subscribe and please do composting. Thank you.